morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday. Welcome, welcome. Let us get settled in. Grab your cup. All right, power of positivity. So let's see what Coffee with Colby has for us today. Here we go. Okay. You keep looking. You ask your guide, where are you? Why can't I see you? Maybe your guide is busy watching your back and taking care of you and doesn't have time to stand in front of you. This is about trust in knowing that they are with you. And that's actually really funny because I have a social media post coming up today about the exact same thing. So I think that's actually really funny. Let us dive into the power of positivity, because a lot of people don't realize the energy that we carry. So when you are having a difficult time, or when you're feeling stressed, or when you're not feeling your best, right? Your vibration is a bit low. If you kind of stay in that place, you'll just kind of keep recreating it. You'll recreate it over and over. You'll actually attract it more and more. And I know that can be stressful, right? Because I don't want to make you stressed out. Like, oh my God, Colby, if I have a bad thought, am I going to make more of it? No, the important part is when you are experiencing it, how do you reframe that? How do you reframe that within your mind and within your body to make it positive? And that's really important, because that positive vibration is A, stronger than the negative, and will attract more positivity. And so when you start to attract more positivity, then it actually will pull you out of that lower vibration naturally. So that positive thinking is positive thinking about yourself, positive thinking about others, about your situation, understanding that things happen for a reason. Not everyone is meant to be in your life forever, and perhaps that soul contract is finished, or that job as well. Maybe you're meant to move past that position and you've been staying in it because it's your safe place and they're pulling you out of your comfort zone. So a lot of times you're going to be pulled out of your comfort zone. So you may feel a dip down. You may feel a dip down, meaning your positive vibe is feeling lower because you're afraid, because you're being triggered, because you know, it's a new beginning, or you're putting trust in yourself. I mean, that's a big thing too, right? We have a lot of trouble putting trust in ourselves sometimes, don't we? And we have a hard time believing that we can do anything, even though we're told it, and even though there's so many examples of people out there being amazingly successful, sometimes we can be the hardest on ourselves. And so it really is that inner knowing and that inner trust that is imperative to your success. And the more you remain positive, then the more it is likely to come to you. If you're not feeling super positive, all right, like let's say you're not feeling it, but you know you need to. You're like, all right, Colts, I'm not feeling it, girl. I'm not here, but I know I need to. How do we do that? It is about going inward to say, how would I need to go about something? What would I need to look at in order to feel this way? Or what would I tell my friend? You know, what would you kind of tell another person? Moreover, you're much kinder to another person than you are to yourself, right? So if you're not going to talk to yourself in a positive way, what would you say to your friend if they came to you? Now start reframing that inside your mind and start speaking to yourself that way. Put up some positive affirmations. You know, I did this thing. I can't show you because I'm on the phone. So I've got this like thing coming out. I know I've been kind of teasing it a bit. I'm about to share it very, very soon. But I'm coming out with this really cool thing next month. And so I created this thing for your phone, and it is a positive mantra. And I thought, well, let me put it on my phone first and just kind of, you know, make sure it works. My mind was like to make sure it works, like functionally, right? I have to tell you, it has totally turned my life around. Like every time I look at it, my day is brightened. So reframing what we say to ourselves and reframing what we say to another, and being mindful, are you projecting? Being mindful, are you owning your stuff? Are you being accountable But also, are you getting in your own way? Are you believing in yourself? You know, believing in yourself is so important. And even if you don't know the steps to take, it certainly is being kind and positive to yourself. But if you sit in, all right, if you sit in that negativity and that kind of insecurity space, if you sit in it, you're only going to create more of it. Okay. And then it will become harder and harder and harder to move past it. So it is kind of being kind to yourself, being gentle to yourself, you know, looking at what is positive. We are all in development, all right? Like, no one is there, all right? And if someone tries to tell you they have all the answers and they are all there and they are the way, you have to know that they got some inner work to do, all right? Because you're never, at no point ever, are you always there. You will be developing not only in this physical life, but beyond this physical life. So even when you transition, all right, so even beyond, there's those soul developments, that soul growth. So we are continuously learning and growing, okay? However, you can take reflection. You are allowed to say, oh my gosh, I used to think this way and there has been some growth in it. I used to look at myself that way and now I can be kinder and loving to myself and I can be gentler to others and I can be more patient and more understanding. So it's looking at where you've come from as well. Also, not being victim to your circumstances. It's easy to fall victim or play victim. It is easy to kind of get into that space, but take accountability, you know, understand that, yeah, you may have come from some trauma or some circumstances. You may have been in something too long. You may have not been as self-loving. However, everything that you have been through has been to prepare you for where you are now and to prepare you for the future and to prepare you for your message to help and heal others. So when you look at it that way, you'll realize you wouldn't want to change anything. You know, you wouldn't want to change it because then how are you going to help others if you hadn't experienced it? And so understanding like, hey, I've been through this and it wasn't fun and I certainly don't want to do that again. You're going to help others who are experiencing it or you're going to help others who are going through it. And you're going to help others find a way to move through it more quickly if that is what your experience has been for you, right? If you were in it too long, you want to say, hey, how do we facilitate this to happen sooner for someone else? So understanding that. Now, the other thing, too, is to look at people who really are seemingly in that position. I don't want to change anything, but I don't like the place I am now. I definitely think if you don't like where you are, we have to kind of look at where we do want to change, though, right? Because if you don't like where you are, then it's not working. And the only way it will work is through change. And so it's finding out then how can we change or what needs to be changed? Where is it not happy? Where is the not happy place that then needs the change? That's where it kind of takes that self-discipline and that courage to kind of go, all right, I got to work through this. I don't want to. Listen, none of us want to go through some of the hard stuff. All right. None of us are signing up for heartbreak. None of us are signing up for rejection. None of us are signing up to get fired or laid off. Okay. None of us are signing up for self-sabotage. However, we may find ourselves in it and we may find ourselves part of that energy. So it is about saying, how do I break through? How do I move through this? What do I need to do? And that self-discipline, that courage is needed more than ever. It's knowing you deserve more. It's knowing there's an inner light there. It's knowing that your potential is limitless, all right? Limitless. And so when you are in it, you can sit there and go, okay, what's my first step? How can I do it? And the other thing too is start writing down positive thoughts and messages, okay? It's writing down things that you would tell another and then adapting them to yourself. Also, like, what would you tell your child self? If you knew what you were going to get in now as an adult and you knew that as a youth, what would you tell yourself? And you might say, run from that person. I think there's a few people that I would go, run, run, little Colbs, run fast as the wind. But, you know, they teach us a lesson. We learn, we grow, and you heal. You can heal from anything. You really can. And going through it only makes you stronger, only makes you in a position to realize how strong. But when you can say, hey, listen, this is what you're going to learn. You're going to experience this, but this is what you're going to learn from it. That's also going to help create that balance and also help you create your message. What is your message? What is your healing superpower? You have a healing superpower, and it's for you first, right? Your healing superpower is for you first, then it's for others. So it's being willing to work through your own stuff and work through where you are, and then taking that and understanding what is needed and what we all go through to help another. And if we did that, if you took the time to kind of raise the vibe for others and put yourself out there in a positive way, you're automatically going to feel better. Do you realize, here's the thing, it's actually proven that if you put your energy on another to make their day brighter or to help them feel better, in that moment, you cannot feel bad about yourself. So in the moment of giving, you cannot be self-loathing. You cannot have self-pity because you're in the presentness, mindfulness of giving. And so try that, you know, try that, and that will really help. And, you know, you are, listen, guys, you are going to have these times where you're not feeling super great. You're going to cry, all right? You're going to have times where you're going to cry. You're going to have times where you feel lost. You're going to have times where you don't know which way is up. It's normal, and we all go through it. That's your body's way. That's your system's way of processing. We need to process our emotions. We need to process our experiences. That's where the growth comes from. If you don't process it and you just shove it down, it's only going to bubble up later. And it could bubble up in negative ways through sugar addiction, drugs, alcohol, negative habits, toxic relationships. It can bubble up in other ways, depression. So, you know, it is important to process it, but you don't want to stay in it longer than what's needed. You don't want to stay in it because it becomes your safety place, okay? You really want to say, all right, I'm processing it and I am working through this. I've got to say it with a not a naughty word. Hang on. I am eager. I am powerful in moving past this. I know there's more for me. I know I can do this. And having that positive thinking is going to help. I am not going to let anyone or anything, any situation or any circumstance dim my light. Now, you may get set back a little bit. All right. You will. Like sometimes, you know, because things will hit you unexpectedly. But you are stronger than that, all right? You are stronger than that, okay? And so just knowing that you can, knowing you hold the power, you hold the power of positivity in your life. If you are not feeling positive because you are giving away your energy to someone else, you have to look at that. Why are you doing that? Why are you letting someone else or someone's word or something be more powerful than you? And as you can see, we all deal with it. I posted yesterday about my negative Nelly person, right? You know, but once you address it, if you address it, you can release it. If I can address it, I can release it. Remember that. All right. So I can address it. I can release it and hit it head on, face on. That's the other thing too, really quick, is when you're dealing with something, sometimes it's really, it feels overwhelming to hit it head on. Whether that's your finances, it could be your personal finances, it could be your personal relationship, it could be where you're feeling stuck in your career, your life, could be your personal health, okay? When you face it head on, you take away the power that it has over you. And it's hard. I mean, how many times do you go back and forth? Should I make this decision? Should I not make it? Is it good for me? Is it not? Oh my gosh, go back and forth. The minute you address it head on, the minute you sit there and say, all right, I'm going to untangle this web, all right, you actually begin to feel better. All right, you will feel better. You will feel stronger. You will feel more positive. So the other thing, the last thing I want to say here is spread the positivity. You know, spread it. If you find yourself feeling jealous over someone or something, ask yourself why. Why do I feel jealous? If you don't like something in someone, why do I not like it? What is it about it? And, you know, just look at that. You know, is it something you admire and you don't want to admit it? Is it something you don't want to be like? And that's okay. Let it go. You know, but stand up for who you are, but also work through what is holding you back. And use positivity, because when you do that, you will see the universe will just keep bringing you more. Don't get stuck in this web of negativity, this web of self-loathing, this web of sadness. Because if you do, it literally can rob you of the joy you are meant to have, okay? So that is your Coffee with Colby for today, everybody. This Thursday, I have a really special guest, and she's quite powerful. She actually is this world-famous DJ. Yet she actually became an influencer. She talks about empowerment. She talks about women loving themselves. So this is going to be a really special episode of the Colby Rebel Show. So I want you to tune in, because I do feel like she can absolutely help us. You guys, there's a lot of classes coming up. I've got the Mavis event coming up. We've got so much in the works. So I'm really excited. And, you know, get out there and spread the positivity. If you like this and it helps, spread this today. Send this out. Share it. And tell someone you love them. Put it out there. Put that positive. Rise up. Rise someone up and rise yourself up. Just do it, okay? So I love you guys. Lots of love, everybody. Remember to shine your light and shine it bright. Bye, everybody.